Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nitha Ananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandanang Bande Radhika Charano Dayam Gopijano Samayuktam Bindavanam Vāñśākalpa-taru-vaśya-kipātindu-vibhacu patitānaṁ pāvune-bha-vaiṣṇa-vibhyo-namo-namah mūkaṁ karoti-vācālaṁ paṅgunglaṁ-ghaiti-giriṁ yat-kipātam-haṅga-bandhi-paramānanda-mādhu brindhāvai-tulsi-devvai-piyāvai-kesava-sacha Sna Bhakti Pade Devi Sattva Bhattvai Namo Namah Narayana Namaskritta Naram Chaiva Narottamam Deving Swarasvating Vaisam Tato Jayo Mudir Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadesh Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadhanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagod Varanya Dhyam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishtaduham Tethas Padam Siva Virinchinutam Saranyam Bhitatiham Panutapal Bhavad Dibhutam Pande Mahapurusate Charunar Vindam Yat pāda pallavana kachanda mani chataya Visvurjita kimapigapavadushvadarisha Purnanuragra sasagara saramurti Saradhikamai kadakimam karosha Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Siyadvaita gadadhar sivasadi gaura bhakta binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Ajānulambita bhujau kanaka bodhato Sankirtanaika pitaro kamala yutaksha Vishambaro dijavaro yugadharma palo Bande yagat priyakaro karuna bhataro Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare, Hare. Namami Gange Tavapad Pankajam Sura-sura-sura-surair-vandito-dibbarupam Bhukti-ncha-mukti-ncha-dadasinityam Bhavan-rupe-na-sadan-naranam Ganga-taranga-ravani-ajata-kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tovam bhagam Narayano priyamananga madapaharam Varanasi purapati bhajavi shanatham Vagi sajusha badane Lakshmir jasya chavakshashi yasyaste hide sambhi tvam nishingamaham bhaji. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare, Hare. Bhayam ditiyo vinishati avinivishataha svat ishat apetas viparajaya astriti. Tanamayaya yato avayatvam bhaktaika esham guru devatatma bhayam ditiyo vinivesatah sat ishat apeto savicha viparajaya astriti tanamayaya ato avayatvam bhaktaika esham guru devatatma Gauriya Goshtipati Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Jagadguru told, to save a bonded soul from the prison of Mayadevi, from the fold of Mayadevi, is really impossible, next to impossible, but still possible. Gauriya Goshtipati Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Jagadguru told, to save Ajivatma, bonded soul, from the fort or jail of Mayadevi is really quite impossible or next to impossible. But still it is possible. What a great task it is, what a big task it is. If those who are intelligent, actually, in true sense, those who are intelligent, they can understand. Common people cannot understand what a big task it is, what a big paropokar, what a big benefit Guru Vaishnava want to give to those bonded souls, inconceivable. But it is possible. The sloka is started with some Srimad Bhagavatam. All the time one kind of, you know, fear, some kind of excitement, fear, anxiety following jiva. Always falling. Always, every time. Then never tension free. Then always there is anxiety, everything. What can be the reason? Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran speaking, Bhayam Ditiyo Vinivesataha Sat Ishat Apetasya Viparjaya Asriti. Ishat Apetasya. When Baddha Jiva get diverted from Bhagavan, when they become averse from Bhagavan, then they are feeling some fear. If we are established in Adyaya Gyanatattva, then there is no question of any fear. Where from fear can come? Where from fear can come? Whereas it in Bhagavatam it is written, Kapilji Maharaj speaking, even by fear going to fear. Even fear, I mean Jamraj, also going to fear. Then, what kind of fear can touch our heart? If we are established in Guru Tattva, if we are going to get full kippa of Guru Vaishnava, then Jad Vibheti Swayam Bhayam. In Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, Kapilji Maharaj speaking, Jad Vibheti Swayam Bhayam. Death, I mean Jamraji Maharaj, the demigod, he is also, he is Vaishnav Raj, Vaishnavana, he is also Vaishnav. Out of Dadas Mahajan, 12 Dadas, you know, he is also one, very important. So it is written by Kapilji Maharaj, Jad Vibheti Swayam Bhayam, Bhaye, I mean fear also going to fear. Whom? That is Supreme Lord. That is Advaita Tattva. That is the main question. We are full of anxiety, fear, tension, because of Ditya Vinaya, second, you know, dual conception. We need so many things. We need Patishtha. If you can give me Patishtha, then and only then I can speak Harikatha. Otherwise, not. This is Annavilas. All different kind of anartha, Annavilas going to put us in trouble all the time. In the ocean of miseries, that is the main question. Now, starting from this Bhagavad Sloka, Vayam Ditiyo Vinivishata Sat Ishat Apetosya Viparjaya Sruti. Vishwanath Chakravartipada, all everybody explaining. But we will have to reconcile all contradictory matters. For a long time, it is so contradictory issue. Sarup Tattva, Vigyan or Science of Jiva. Apparently contradictory issues, because from different angle if we discuss, different kind of answer can come, but how to finalize, reconcile. Like one example I can give. For bonded soul, it is really prohibited to open one temple, mat. Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, mat mandir dalanbari nakoro prayas? Don't try to make big buildings and mat mandir. It will be a big problem for you. But Prabhupada's going to establish mat. Also in Srimad Bhagavatam 11th canto, we find Bhagavan Sri Krishna going to advise to Uddhav, man mandir kare dhiram. Hey Uddhav, you will have to make a big temple, very solid temple, very gorgeous. And what is this, Maharaj? Contradictory. Whereas Krishna speaking, man mandir kare dhiram. Karayat dhiram, you will have to make. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Matmandi Dhananbhai Nakara Prayas, don't try to make this kind of, because you cannot. Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking this way? And why Prabhupada going to make 64 moths all around the world? If you cannot reconcile, then you will have to get aparat. You can get aparat. Big problem. You will have to go deep into this issue, try to understand the heart of Guru Vaishnava, why, when, how they are speaking this way, that is the main issue. Surely Bhaktivinoda Thakur not going against Krishna. Surely Bhaktivinoda Thakur not speaking that you should not make big temple and mandir, everything. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking for our bonded souls. Many times Baba speaking, by money power, manpower, if somebody going to think that I can make a Gauriya mat, he is a foolish idiot number one. Baba many times speaking, by money power, manpower, one cannot establish Gauriya mat. One cannot establish a mat. Mat foundation is Nityananda Baladev. If I am not going to enjoy full kipa of Nityananda Balaram, how I can establish mat? I will have to pray so that Gauriya mat can come down to bestow kipa on us from eternal world. Who can do it? Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami Maharaj can do it. Follow? Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj can do it. Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, they can do, they can install deities, they can establish math, but it is not for all. Bhakti Pramod Thakur wanted to give this kind of instruction so that people not going to make a mistake again and again. By money power, manpower, one cannot make a mat, establish a mat. Prabhupada many times told. It become a karma. Prabhupada speaking, when somebody going to make temple, this install this, it become karma, not bhakti. Follow. This way we can reconcile. When Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj speaking, Amar Prabhu, my Prabhu, don't go to Kalir Brahmanda. Don't initiate anybody. Don't make any disciple. Follow. So many instructions. Don't go to Kalir Brahmanda. You know. Don't try to get association of anybody. How to reconcile? Apparently it seems that Prabhupada going to break all the rules and regulations instruction given by Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj. But not that. Prabhupada going to reconcile. I never go to Calcutta. Calcutta means Kalir Brahmanda. I never go to Calcutta. I go to Gauriya Math, Gauriya Mission, which is a transcendental in a place of Harikatha Kirtan, continuously Sankirtan going on there, that Vaikuntha. There I am going. I am not going to break the instruction of my Guru Padma. Surely I am not going to get the association of anybody, because the kind of excellent association I have received from my Guru Padma, after that I am feeling detested. I am not feeling any test to get the association of other people. After getting so many excellent association of my Guru Padma, after getting this kind of, you know, excellent association, I am not feeling any interest to go for other association of other bonded soul. Follow. I am never making any disciple, believe me or not. I am making all guru. They can rectify me if I am going to make any mistake. They are watching me all the time, whether I am making any mistake or not. So they are all my guru. This way, to reconcile this. Now I can come to the point, main point. That Krishna bhuli sei jib anadi bohirmuk. Atayev maya tare dey samsaradi dyug. Or Prabhupada many times wanted to explain this sloka. Brahmanda brahmita guna bhagyavan jib guru Krishna prasade paik bhaktilata bhaktilata bij. Krishna bhuli sei jib anadi bohirmuk. Atayev maya tare dey samsar. So many points are there. Apparently, it seems all contradictory, we cannot reconcile. But first of all, it is your duty to gather full kripa of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Baladev Vidyavasan, Vishwanath Chakravartivad. Follow, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Srila Goswami Maharaj, Keshav Goswami Maharaj, all our Guru Bhargava, full kripa. Then clearly you can see, Maharaj, everything reconciled. No contradiction. So many questions coming to me for the past 5 years regarding this question about the actual sarup of jiva, what is the status of bonded jiva, and what is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, how we can reconcile, how it is possible. Krishna bhuli sei jib, also I started with the point from Bhagavatam, Bhayam Dityo Vinveshata Asat Ishat Apatasya Viparjaya Asriti. It means, it is going to, apparently it seems, there is going to indicate some point of time from where Jiva is going to become averse. But is it true? And why they are going to discuss that way? There is no way out. So many bonded souls are there, countless bonded souls. How many people going to do bhajan of Gauranga Mahaprabhu? Out of them, those who are going to join Gauriya Math, actually, you'll have to sort out. After that, out of them, those who are actually going to, you know, take shelter, oh, 100% sincere. It depends upon my sincerity, how the Guru Vani, Siddhanta Vani can get manifested inside my heart. It depends upon my quality, position, rank. Not that everywhere everybody can understand all Siddhanta okay every time. Maybe one or for the past 2 years or 1 year I am going to answer, but I already told my that answer is not complete. You can remember. Many questions coming to me, but some special question I appreciate. One of my son from Slovenia, he is going to put this kind of question. In the year of 2012, in Chaitanya Guru Maharaj, I was sitting inside doing some seva. Actually, from the very beginning, first when he land in India, he first see me. Because Tithu Maharaj, Bhakti Vallabh Tithu Maharaj, Siksha Guru sent me there. So that I can give some preliminary idea about what is bhakti, what is bhakta in course of my driving to Mayapur, this way. But the first question, remarkable, I remember still today, is putting, Maharaj, is there any new production of jivas? Very nice question, innocent question, I was very happy. Is there any new production of jivas? I say, my son, actually, if we know already that jiva, number of jivas is countless, infinity, then where from you are going to get this kind of inquiry whether new jivas are being produced? Where from this question comes? Whereas we know all jivas, they are nitya, eternally present, and we know all Bhagavan is also eternal. Nitto nityanam stetana stetanam eko bahunam jividadhati kaman. Yes, sloka we know. So where from this question of production of new jivas coming? This question first. Actually, jivas are infinity, they are eternally present. So no question of production of new jivas. Different kind of example giving, sometimes people cannot understand why this example given, how we can harmonize different kind of contradiction. But we will have to draw final conclusion on this chapter on the basis of the kripa of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Baladev Vidyabhushan, Vishwanath Chakravarti Vat, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Kesava Goswami, Sridhar Goswami, Bhaktivinoda, all will have to get full kripa from them. And then we can reconcile. One thing I would like to speak first. Long ago, not now actually, maybe 45 or 50 years ago, I don't know, I forget. I heard from Srila Gopanandaban Maharaj, who is the present, you know, Acharya of Bhajanasram. He loved me very much, bestokib all the time. You know, he one day speaking, Maharaj, long ago when I was very young, that time my Guru Maharaj was there, and Sri Goswami, Maharaj Goswami, all. There was a function in Puri, that time there was some question, that Guru Mukha Padma Bhakcha Hidayata Koriya Vikya Arna Koriya Manehasa. Okay, but all Guru Tattva eternally present. Guru Tattva is, you know, you cannot break this Guru Tattva into pieces. Now, originally Guru Tattva is one and single, but different kind of diversity we find, because our Guru Bhargava coming from Nityananda's lotus feet, or from in Madhur Radha, we from Radharani, Marjada Mark in the way of, you know, Maryada, Nityananda Prabhu, we can take it as granted. From there, Nityai Charan Sattva Tahara Seva Nitya. From there all our Guru Varga coming, why different kind of diversity visible? Suppose Parampujivat Keshav Goswami Maharaj speaking, to hear and chant about that Yama Kirtan is not necessary at present. You will have to hear Harikatha from the lotus mouth of pure Guru Vaishnav and go on changing your heart. Try to throw away all the dirty matters, they are already garbage there inside your heart. When you can get sufficient purity, then and only then you can realize that what is rasa, this, that, not now. Even Maharaj wanted to publish Jaiva Dharma exclusive of that rasa tattva. He wanted to cut and rasa tattva separately, not for all. Now, if we are going to find fault with Keshav Goswami Maharaj, why he is doing? He should not do Bhaktivinoda Thakur done. But out of his humble attitude, causeless mercy is going to show us the exact way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing everything, but sometimes we cannot understand. And in the preface writing of Yama Kirtan, Srila Prabhupada also, Bhajan Rahasa writing so many things, also Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj also writing, they are going to conclude that in bonded condition, really, it is not so urgent. Bonded condition, bonded soul can misunderstand. But our Prabhupada Madhav Goswami Maharaj, he is so merciful, he wanted to give up chance that by the association of Guru Vaishnava, we can go on chanting this, you know, Jama Kirtan, so that someday devotees can. Parampuja Bharati Maharaj used to say, somebody misunderstand, misinterpret, try to, you know, take undue advantage of this point, but Maharaj, he told me, I know it for sure, that Guru Maharaj never to misuse it. He wanted to, so mercifully wanted to say, in front of all exalted Vaishnava, if I am going to feel karma, then I should be kicked out of bhajan field. Are in front of Gurudev, in front of Keshav Goswami Maharaj, how I can feel karma? Eh? In front of sun, how I can feel darkness? That is the main point. Bharati Maharaj told Maharaj, Guru Maharaj never wanted to misuse it. Guru Maharaj was so merciful, he wanted to say, okay, ultimately, if they are going to sing this song under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava, they understand, they are sincere, someday they can get entry into Raghadeva. Out of his causeless mercy. But if somebody is going to misuse this point, then what Srila Bhaktivedanta, my Gurudev Bhaktivedanta Madhav Goswami, what he can do? That is the main point. The preface writing of Srila Prabhupada, the preface, you know, second preface writing by Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami, all going to prove that it is suitable for Mukta Purush. But not that we can arrange our bondage condition forever. Prabhupada speaking. It is not that I am going to speak, it is not now. Not now, Prabhupada speaking. That doesn't mean I want to arrange so that all, you know, devotees are for infinity pure, they can stay in bonded condition. I am not going to speak that way. Try to understand what I mean to say. Prabhupada speaking, I am speaking so heavily, I am giving so many restrictions, that doesn't mean we will have to arrange our bondage condition forever. Not that. It is, try to understand what I mean to say. We should never be sahajiya. Better we can die. Sahajiya procedure is prohibited. That's why I am so strict. That doesn't mean I am not going to approve this asata. People misunderstand, misinterpret. That is the main point. So what is the point of view of Parampuja Keshav Goswami Maharaj? What is the point of view of, you know, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj? What is the point of view of Bhakti Bhavan, Bhakti Rakha, Siddhar Goswami, you know, Bhakti Vita Madhav Goswami? Try to reconcile. Try to reconcile. Don't try to fight. So, one question was there. That Guru Mukha Padma Hidayat Kuriya Kar, okay, But if we try to harmonize our Guru Pad Padma totally, what kind of teachings I am getting? Another time we find Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami speaking this way. Paramahansa, you know, Madhu Goswami speaking this way. Then we cannot find, we cannot tally, we cannot reconcile. And whereas you already told the Guru Tattva all originalism, then how to reconcile? Then everybody present there, they give, they request Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj to solve this problem. Guru Pad Padma Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Paramahansa Gurudev started speaking that my son, in short I am speaking, not in details what was there that time, in short. My son, actually, we are supposed to get entry into Raganuga Bhajan. All our Guru Bhargava, eternal Prasad of Radharani, Gauranga Mahaprabhu said, surely. But for those bonded soul, conditioned souls, we are arranging Gauriyamat Bhajan under the strict rules and regulation of Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada. If we can get habituated in this, you know, Vidhi Mark. Vidhi Mark is not opposite to Ragma. This is the main point on the basis of which everybody fighting. On this point, everybody fighting. They don't try to understand. Bhaktivinoda Thakur that this Ragmarg is not contradictory to Vidhi Mark. Apparently, it seems Vidhi Marge Krishna Bhakti nahi paita nahi shakti. Okay, it's right. That doesn't mean we'll have to throw Vidhi Mark and throw. Not that. Bhaktivinoda is speaking. Vidhimar Bhajan ultimately going to help us to get entry into Raganuga Bhajan. This point I can explain big way after some time. All discussion what I am going to do, be sure under the guidance of Baladev Vidyavoshan, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Keshav Goswami, all. I am not going to make any personal philosophy in it. It's offensive. But sometime I can give some example, which is of course not objectionable. I think so. Scientific example I can, I am free. I think you also permit me to do that, to clarify those matters, you know. This way, you see, Guru Padman speaking, Prabhupada arranged this Vidhi Marg Bhajan, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also admit and give, show us this procedure of Gauriyamat Bhajan, very, very strictly, right from the 3 o'clock in the morning, you know, we'll have to follow rules and regulations. Bonded soul naturally against any strict regulation. They are very angry. They become very angry. If I speak heavily, they become angry. Instantly, they can cut my relationship with them. If I speak heavily. That is a tragedy. Where to speak, how to speak, when to speak, whom to speak. I am very anxious about that. But I cannot break the instruction of Prabhupada. I will have to follow. If you like or don't like what to do, I will have to follow Prabhupada ultimately. Guru Bhargava. So this way, you see, Guru Bhargava speaking, Prabhupada giving this arrangement in Gauriyamat Bhajan. So strict rules and regulation we are following, and we can gradually get habituated under the guidance of Guru Vishnav. Also, if there is no kapat bhav, no duplicity, then surely a jivatma can make gradual promotion in the way of bhajan. And on a suitable time period, Guru Bhargava can best to keep on him so that you can understand what is ragmarg, how to get entry. This all can be done. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in Jaiva Dharma, Jaiva Dharma also writing in different way, and also in Bhajan Rahasya, Vidhi Margo Rato Jane, Sadhinata Ratna Dane, Rag Marge Karai Pravesh. Vidhi Margo Rajane, those who are going to keep themselves under the guise of strict rules and regulation of Guru Varga, Vidhi Margo Rato Jane, ultimately, Sadhinata Ratna Dane, Rag Marge Karai Pravesh, can give me liberty to get entry into Ragmarg, not before. Our position is so painful, a bonded condition is so painful, so miserable condition, that they only think about They want to become free, bodily bondage and mental bondage. But is that all? They are going to express their feeling. We cannot follow this bodily bondage or your material mind is there, material bondage. Material bondage is there, material mind. So if people, bonded people, going to agitate, start, you know, shouting slogan, we cannot obey, we cannot obey, we can, what we can do? Is that all? If we like to get liberation, bodily liberation and mental liberation, is that all you can prove? You come in front of me. Can you prove that is that all? Can you prove it can give you all benefit? Then why you are going to, you know, maintain your mental bondage, bodily bondage? Okay, Maharaj, don't disturb me. I like to maintain the bondage is very good for me. I can get some taste, you know, some sweet, some bitter, some, you know, sour. I can get different four type of taste, you know, Chaturvidha. So they like to lead their life this way. They like to make their life tasty. But when you can get transcendental taste, then you can throw, kick, make urine. It can make urine on previous test. But you don't understand this point. False ego there. So this way actually, you know, Vidhi Marga Ratu Jane, Sadhinata Ratna Dane, Rag Marga Koraya Pavis. So, bodily liberty or mental liberty, is that all? It is very painful. It is very painful, you don't try to understand. We devotees like to be controlled by Guru Vaishnava. That is our ultimate goal. We want to be controlled by Guru Vaishnava perfectly. Because ultimately, this kind of controlling by Guru Maharaj, they are going to put some rules and reason on me, ultimately going to make me free, giving actual liberty in true sense. When I can love Krishna from heart and Krishna can love me from heart, then I can get free access all over this infinite world. No restriction. When I can love Krishna, there is no restriction. That is called liberty. But first of all, bondage to want to get liberty. And they don't like to follow any rules and regulations. Nothing. They become very angry. So, Vidhi Marga Ratu Jane, Sadhinata Ratna Dane, Raga Marga Karaya Pravesh. Guru Padma speaking, Vidhi Marga said by Prabhupada is very, very beneficial. And the question you are putting, Guru Padma speaking, that this Gurudev speaking this, another Gurudev speaking this, so you cannot reconcile. So the question was there, how to follow this point? Guru Padma speaking, be careful. Nityananda Prabhu coming in your life, Nityananda Prabhu coming in your life in the form of Banadev Goswami Maharaj. Nityananda Prabhu coming in the form of Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj in my life. Nityananda Prabhu coming in the form of Keshav Goswami in your life. So there can be some apparent diversity, speciality. But ultimately, if you go to the original Siddhanta, you can find all tally. All. This we'll have to know the technique. This mathematics is very sensitive mathematics, very high. Higher mathematics can fail here. Devotional mathematics can help you to get to reconcile. How possible? Then Guru Padma was bound to speak. Suppose Sira Bhakti Bhagavan Keshava Goswami was speaking this way. And Sira Bhakti Madhu Goswami was speaking this way. Be careful, my son. You will have to first understand what your Guru Maharaj is speaking. You need not jump. First of all, you will have to understand what your Guru Maharaj is speaking to you, what instruction. Maybe there is some speciality. So you will have to follow that. Because according to your sanskar, it is the arrangement of Nityananda, that Nityananda is going to send you in front of Bhakti, you know, Hridaya Banadev Goswami Maharaj. So you will have to follow in toto Guru's instruction. After that, if some Siksha Guru, like in Guru Bhargava speaking some special, if you at all cannot understand, you will have to approach a pure Guru Vaishnava. They can reconcile. Otherwise, you can gradually develop dissatisfaction, doubt, and sangsayatma vinaswati. Maybe Bhakti Dvaita Madhu Goswami is speaking wrong, maybe Kesava Goswami is speaking right, or maybe Kesava Goswami is wrong. This is not good. So it was the instruction of Bhakti Pohatpuri Goswami Guru Pad Padma that first of all, Nityananda coming in the form of your Guru Pad Padma. So you will have to follow him first. After that, if at all any disparity if you find of Siddhanta with your some other Guru Bhargava, you will have to come, you have to bring this point in front of pure devotees, exalted devotees, Siddhanta beat. They can find solution for you. You can find very okay. This is the point. Now so many questions coming. I can also read some question, maybe some coming days, not today, because I will have to make some background, though I already discussed this point long ago, maybe 1 year or more than that. But still I was not satisfied. I was supposed to start another new topics, and this was lying unsolved. So by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, by your all mercy, I like to find a very, very suitable solution which is acceptable for all Guru Varga. There cannot be any fighting on this point. This I like to, you know, speak in front of you. But first of all, main point is that Krishna Bhuli Seiji Anadi Vairamukh. I can discuss this point day after days. It will take long time. Though it is in the final touch, but still it will take long time. I have to give argument one by one, Sasa Siddhanta. Krishna Bhuli Seiji Anadi Vairamukh. Anadi Bini, there is no time bound, no starting point. So what do you mean to say? Bhaktivinoda was speaking, in the time period of material time period, there is no starting. So what do you mean to say? When Bhaktivinoda was giving so many argument about Tathastha Jiva, we know. But the Jiva is all Tathastha Jiva. What do you mean by Tathastha Jiva? Many things, very important thing I already discussed. But still, again, I like to remind you. What do you mean by Tathastha? Philosophically, we know Tathastha means there is a marginal point. Like water and land. Water and land, if there is one demarcation, fine demarcation, is called Tathastha. Bhaktivinoda Thakur many times explaining this point. Bandha Jeev is Tathastha Jeev. Tathastha because they are suitable for both. They are, those bonded souls, they are both suitable for this Maya Jagat, also suitable for Nitya Jagat. That's why they are Tathastha. Tathastha doesn't mean in this infinity world you will have to find some position where all Tathasthas are lying, you will have to catch them and bring here. Yes, you know, very important point. Krishna Bhuli Seijiv Anadi Bahirmukh Atvaip Mayatare Daya Samsaraditu. Follow what I say. Now I want to break some wrong conception. I am going to start with Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda speaking, for the long time this is, you know, contradictory issues, all everybody fighting on this issue. They cannot find a perfect solution in this matter, or at all if Guru Bhargava is saying, we cannot support, we cannot understand how it is possible. Follow what I say. Krishna Bhuli Seiji Anadi Bahirmukh. Did this we understand? For infinity pure jivas are in bonded condition. Anadi Bahirmukh means bonded condition. We know all jivas, they are coming from Tathastha Shakti. This we know. Follow. Diversity in unity and unity in diversity. Krishna is the cause of all causes, anadi radi govinda sarva karana karana. And wherefore diversity coming in Advaita Gandhi? Well, Maharaj, originally it is there in Krishna. Originally this diversity was already there. Not that diversity was created and manufactured after. Diversity also eternally present. If diversity eternally present, then we will have to understand diversity eternally present. That's mean? What do you mean? Bhaktivinoda Thakur want to speak that all eternally Siddha Bhakta, they can be divided into two parts, segregate, basically. One is Vidhi Bhakta, another is Rag Bhakta. Follow what I say. Nitya Siddha Bhakta, eternally Siddha Bhakta, they can be divided. I can come back to the original part again. Some here and there, northeast, I will have to go and bring some documents from different way to reconcile. So first of all, I start with this point, which is very sensitive. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Nitya Siddha Bhakta, they can be divided into two parts. You know it very well. One group is Vidhi Bhakta, another is Rag Bhakta, by the Divido. Again, Nitya Siddha Divido, and Nitya Siddha Rag Bhakta Pratyek, you know, we know Nitya Siddha Vidhi Bhakta is there, Nitya Siddha Rag Bhakta, and each of them, from each group, they have some speciality about Dasya, Sakya, Guru, Kanta. When I am going to conclude, then also I am starting and I am speaking. When I am going to conclude, again I can discuss this point. To draw final conclusion. And diversity of Krishna eternally present, I can show you like mathematical calculation. So Dasa, Sakya, Guru, you know, Kanta, all can be there from both group, Vidhi Bhakta, Nitya Siddha Bhakta or Rag Bhakta can be there, Chaturvida, all. Because in Chaitanya Charitamrita, middle part of Chaitanya Charitamrita, you know, 24 chapter, you know, Madhya Khanda, 24th chapter and 283 sloka, it is written, Nitya Siddha Parishad Das, dot, 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 I am not speaking everything. I am going to omit some point, because no need. So, after that is written, Nitya Siddha Parishad Das, Sakha Guru Kanta Gon Chari Vido Prakas, four different kind of division in both the group, those who are Vidhi Mark Bhakta, Ragma Bhakta, both. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, Nitya Siddha Parishad Das, Sakha, Guru, Kanta, Gan, and four different classification. And in the Bhashya, Amrita Prabha Bhashya, and Anubhashya also, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada is going to touch Amrita Prabha Bhashya. I am going to give the gist. Anyway. It is written, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada, both same thing. Parishad Gani Nitya Siddha. Those who are eternal Parsad, be sure they are eternally present. Nitya Siddha. They are all Guru. Those who are eternally Parsad, Parishad Gani Nitya Siddha. Those who are Parishad eternal Parsad, they are Nitya Siddha, eternally Siddha. Follow. And also there can be some classification. From Baladev Shankarsan, Prakatita Jivgan, Nitya Siddha. From Baladev, some countless Jivatmas coming, Shankarsan, Baladev Shankarsan, Prakatita Jivgan, they are Nitya Siddha. They are not Baddha. They are all Guru. Baladev Shankarsan, Prakatita, from Baladev Shankarsan, some jiva, countless jivas coming. They are jiva gone, they are nitya siddha. They are guru. They are eternally doing seva of Krishna. Out of your jealousy, if you are going to, you know, pass this kind of wrong conception, they are bonded soul, then you can get some aparad. They are coming from, they are also jiva. Prakriti jiva. They are actually eternally present. It is the arrangement of Nityananda, Baladev. They are all guru. They are not never bonded. They never saw bonded condition. They are eternally mukta. And those 12 Dadas Gopal, 12 Gopals, always staying with, you know, Krishna, Dadas Gopaladi, they are coming from, they are actually expansion. From Baladev they are coming. They are not jeev. Follow what I say. From Baladev Sankarsan, going to manifest countless jiva, they are nitya siddha, they are eternally serving Krishna, it's all okay. Out of jealousy, if I am going to pass remark, wrong remark, then I can develop aparad. They are not jeev. You know, they are not ordinary jeev. You know. Dadas, all those 12 different Gopal, cowherd boys, playing with Krishna, they are not jeev. Upper, when I discuss Baladev Sankarsan Prakatito Jeevgar Nitya Siddha, they are not ordinary jeev, bonded soul, they are not. They are guru, you know. And Dadas Gopal and other, you know, Parsadip coming from Baladev, they are not at all jeev. They are Baladev Abhinna, non-different from Baladev. They are non-different from Baladev. They are Vigraha, as same as Baladev. Dadas Gopal Adi, they are. Whole jivas can be separated into three parts. One is Baddha Jiva, one is Tatastha, another is Mukta. You know, Baddha, Tatastha and Mukta. One nice writings by Srila Prabhupada also already translated, you know, by me. I can show you after some time, not today maybe. Baddha, Tatastha, Mukta. Paraspar Prithak. They are all different from each other. Each category has some speciality or not same. And also, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to write this very important, and some question coming to me for a long time also, they can get answer of this question. Sarupe, all those Dvip Jiva Sarup, Tatastha Bhav is there in fine form. Try to understand scientific point. Again, when I can draw conclusion, again I can come back to this point. In the middle, you will have to understand. All discussion going on, all the way. In Sarup of Jiva, Tatastha Bhav is there in fine form, very fine form. Materially, you cannot find. Sarup, in Sarup of all Jiva, Tatastha Bhav is there in fine form. Externally, you cannot discover. Be careful. Actually, Baddha Jiva is not materially Tatastha. What I mean to say, you cannot find any zone. You cannot find, practically, you cannot find any zone where you can find all but the, you know, Tatastha Jeev there, you have to pull them from there. Not there. I can give scientific evidence of that. Bhaktivinoda speaking, in Sarupa of Jiva, Tatastha Bhav is in fine form there. All different kind of example given by Bhaktivinoda Thakur is not useless. Follow. You can say why Bhaktivinoda Thakur from Brihad Aranyaka Upanishad giving this example, so it is confusion, not that. I can give argument in favor of this Siddhanta. It is not useless. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was bound to give this example. Baladev Goswami, Vidyavasan Goswami is also speaking like same, almost. Follow what I say. So, Baddha, Tatastha, Mukta is each of three categories different from each other, not. But Sarupa and Sarupa, Jiva, Tatastha, Bhav can be there in fine form. Must be there in fine form. Can be there. Because it depends. If Tatastha Bhav already, you know, they already enter, they can be Nitya Siddha, they can join them. So, you know, Sarup in Sarup Tatastha Bhava can be there in fine form, but Bhattajeev is not actually Tatastha. I mean, you cannot find any zone where you can go and detect all Bhattajeevas there. Bhattajeev, not there. Bhattajeev Tatastha Nai. It is imagined, it is not useless. This is not actually useless imagination, not there. Sometimes theory can support practicality. So I can give you example. Maya Kabalito Yagit. So, you know, they are found to be in the lap of Maya. You know, Maya Kabalito Yagachi. Atae Baddha. About Mukta also, those who are Mukta, eternally they are Mukta. They never, they saw bonded condition. Then where from this conception coming? I can give one by one argument. Mukta Sambandha, about Mukta, those who are Mukta already are told. They are also Tatastabhav Sunna. In Sarupa, they are in fine form there. But Tatastabhav Sunna. Because in Chaitanya Jivati, you already know many times. Nitya Mukto Nitya Krishna Charane Unmuk. Follow what I say. Chaitanya Chaitamito Madhya Gando 22 chapter 11, 12 slogan speaking. Try to understand. Whereas Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is saying, we will have to reconcile. How possible? It's contradictory. We have some many kind of doubts and suspicion. Nitya Mukta Nitya Krishna Charane Unmuk. Nitya Mukta Nitya Krishna Charane Unmuk. Krishna Parishad Nam Bhunjaye Sevasuk. We already Bhaktivinoda Thakur told. Saham Jivatmas, they are countless Jivas are coming. They are eternally Siddha. They are busy with Seva. They never saw Maya. They are all Guru. Baladev Shankarsan from there. If somebody is going to compare them with bonded soul, it's very bad. But especially about those Dadas, Mahajan and other, those are coming directly from the expansion of Baladev, as well as same as Baladev. They are not Jiva. They are non-different from Baladev Vigraha. So also Baddha Tatastha Mukta. Now in Chaitanya Charitamrita, in Chaitanya, in Sanatana Sikha, we find so many terms. Example, Nitya Mukta, Nitya Unmuk, Krishna Parshat, Nitya Baddha, Nitya Bahirmuk, Nitya Sangsa, so many terms. How to, you know, how to reconcile. So you try to understand Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Kanda 22, 11, 12. I like to cite this example first, which is example given by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, to identify their respective position and rank. Nitya Mukta, who? Those who are eternally doing seva. Nitya Mukta, Nitya Krishna Charane Unmu. They never saw Maya. Krishna Parishad Nam, Bhunjaya Seva Sukh. They are eternally serving Krishna. They are Parshad also. They are called Parshad. Parshad Jivas. Krishna Parishad Nam, Bhunjaya Seva Sukh. Another point, Nitya Baddha Krishna Haite Nitya Bahirmukh. Those who are eternally bonded condition, Nitya Baddha Krishna Haite Nitya Bahirmukh. They are eternally averse from Krishna. Eternally they are engaged in Sangsar, Nitya Sangsar. They are always getting sometime material enjoyment, sometime they are sent to hell, bhunje narakadi dukh. Sometimes they are going to go, kobhu, raja kobhu poja. Sometimes they become king, sometimes become, you know, beggar. Infinity brahmanda, this kind of, you know, brahmanda bhamita guna bhagava jeev, guru krishna, guru krishna prasada pai bhakti lata bij. This word is applicable for those nitya bhadha, eternally they are bhadha. Eternally bhadha doesn't mean that bonded condition can never be finished. Jiver nit, jiver bandhan dasa, the bonded condition of jiva eternally present, that doesn't mean they cannot cut their bondage, they can never become devotee. It's not that. This is the point. Nitya mukta, those jiva, they never saw maya. They have no relationship with maya. They are in transcendental dham. They are always, you know, doing seva, favorable seva to Krishna all the time. Positive seva. Parishad. Krishna sevan muk. They are going to enjoy seva sukh. By doing seva of Krishna, they are going transcendental bliss, bhog, sukha. Krishna seva sukhi tadet bhog. They are not going to search out any separate bhog, like material bondage, bonded soul. And nitya baddha jiva sab, those eternally bonded, a sakal, they are eternally averse from Krishna. You know, always traveling in these 14 worlds, in this material world, sometimes they are going to heaven, coming down to hell, this way. And this aversive attitude there, for their aversive attitude, maya going to give them treatment. This sthula, gross body and fine body, they are getting punishment. I can discuss this point. Now this is a basic point you try to understand first. Follow what I say. The very basic point you will have to understand. Now I like to give one by one argument you try to understand. That nitya nityanam chetano chetanam eko bahunam javidhati kaman. Is sloka going to surely say us that Mayavadi, they are liar. They are going to believe on one unique Jivatma. Jiv. Atma, one and single. They are not going to confess. They are going, not going to, you know, believe that there is countless Atma. First point, defect of Mayavad. They are going to explain in this way that one unique Atma is there, Brahmo, and Brahmo, when going to get reflected in different pots of water or mirror, different kind of conception growing. But Shastra, Upanishad, Vedanta, Bhagavatam, Chaitanya never is written. Their conception is totally wrong. Ek Jivatma Bhat. They believe in one unique Jivatma, Brahmo. They don't believe. But in Shastra, never it is written. So, nitya, nityanam, chetana, chetanam, eko, bahunam, it is written at all. Upanishad going to confess that jiva, bonded soul, they are also infinity. And category I already told. Now I am going to deal with bonded soul. I like to show you. So, nitya, nityanam, chetana, chetanam, eko, bahunam, javidhati kaman. This Krishna is the cause of infinity, Brahmanda is infinity, Jivatma, everything. Who is going to start argument about this point? Prabhupada already told many times, Jagadguru Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Paramahansa speaking, Bhakti is a natural function of soul. This is also a very important point. How to tell it? But why not manifest it? Bhakti, we cannot see Bhakti inside Jiva. inside jiva. We cannot see manifested. Chidatma cannot see or feel that absolute tattva due to the covering of maya. They cannot feel. They are under covering of maya. That's why they cannot feel that Chidatma is Gyanamaya, Anandamaya, Chidatma also. Bhagavan, Anandamaya, Gyanamaya. Yanma adasya yato anmayadi turascharta sabhikya sarata tene brahma idaj adi kavai mayanti yat surayo teyo vari medam yatha vinimayo tisargaham misa dhanya seno nirast kuhakam sattam param dhimahi. So this way you see, Bhagavan is Anandamaya, absolute Anandamaya. Bhagavan is absolute Gyanamaya. You know, Anandamaya, Gyanamaya, absolute Bhumika. He is the absolute platform, Bhagavan. So, you see, everything there eternally present in Krishna. And Jivas, they are also Gyanamaya. But the Gyanamaya Anuchaitanya, but still, their gain is covered up by Maya. Chit Atma, which is residing inside our heart, cannot see or feel that absolute Tattva. That's why we need to depend upon Guru Vaishnava. Bhayam Dityo Vinivashat, Bhayam Dityo Vinivashat Asat, Ishat Apatasya Viparya Sriti, Tan Mayaya Ato Avayatvam, Bhaktaik Esham Gurudeva Tatma. Then we'll have to serve that Gurupad Tatma, then we can feel, not before that. Because Bhadda Jeev under the covering of Maya cannot feel. After all, the soul has been transforming through 84 lakhs of different species. You know. Aisajyasya samagyasya virjasya jasasya sriyo jnana vairagyasya chaiva sara iti bhaga ingana. All eternally present in absolute form in Krishna. But in jiva, not absolute. Very, very teeny, infinitesimal. So, Chidatma is siding inside our heart, cannot see. That Jivatma cannot see or feel that absolute Tattva due to the covering of Maya, illusion. After all, the soul has been transmigrating through 84 lakhs of different species of lives since beginningless time period. There is no beginning. Where from Jivatma traveling? Krishna Bali says, Anadi Bhairamu. We cannot point out in starting, beginning, endless, infinity. Since beginning, you know, beginningless time, there is no beginning for the infinity period there. Whereas the Jiva Sarup is eternally fixed. How? That I can point out. That is the main point. Infinite, infinitesimal chit particle jivatma coming from the tatastha sakti or marginal potency of Supreme Lord Sri Krishna. So naturally, jivatma is related to Krishna according to achinta vidavet tattva. Ved and aved both right. Both okay. Those jivatmas are part and parcel of Supreme Lord. Bhagavan Sri Krishna in Gita, na mamaiva amsa jiva loka jiva bhuta sanatanaha. But counterpart of Krishna is not possible. Follow. Counterpart is not that. Mamaiva amsa jiva loka jiva bhuta sanatanaha means shakti shakti matar aved according to Vedanta Sutra. So they are Shakti Angsa. There is some special Shakti, marginal energy, Tatasya Shakti, Jivatma, though all those countless Jiva they are coming from. Follow, Tatasya Shakti, Jiva. Follow. And those who are coming from Baldevji Maharaj, eternally they are doing seva. You know, that Jiva is totally different. They are Guru, our Nitya Parsad. So, infinitesimal chit particle, Jivatma coming from Tatastha Shakti, a marginal potency of Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna. So naturally, Jivatma is related to Krishna according to Achintya Vedava Tata. Those jivatmas are part and parcel of Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna, and manifestation of His marginal potency, this much. So naturally, those jivatmas are having both tendency. Both tendency mean they are suitable for Nitya Jagat and they are also suitable for material Jagat. They can feel attraction. Follow. Tendency of attraction for both the Jagat. It depends. Sometime they can feel attraction. It is written according to Tatastha conception. But actually, Tatastha Karsham, I told already, it is in fine form inside Jiva. Materially, you cannot find. So you think it is false philosophy. But I can prove it is not false philosophy. In fine form, it is there in Tatastha, in Jiva Saru. But not in, you know, practically here you cannot find. So that is not false conception that I can prove. So why Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to prove about Tatastha Jiva? Some quotation Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying from, you know, from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, Tasso vai tasso purushasya de eva sthane bhavato idancha paro lokasthanancha sandhyam tritiyam sapna sthanam tasmin sandhi. Sthane tishtan ethi Uvesthani Pashyati Idancha Paraloku Sthanancha. Try to understand. Tasho Vaitasho Purushasho De Eva Sthani Bhavata Idancha Paraloku Sthanancha Sandhyam Tritiyam Sapno Sthanam Tasmin Sandhe Sthani Tishtan Ete Uvesthani Pashyati Idancha Paraloku Paro loko sthanancha. Philosophically, Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to make us understand. Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to quote this conception to have a practical feeling. Yeah, it is possible. But actually, that Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak, he is also speaking that Tatastha Je Baba in Sarupa, in fine form, but in, you know, material form you cannot find. So this conception is not at all wrong. I can prove. You know, Jiva suitable for both the position. One is transcendental position and material position. You know, and middle position is compared with one dream. As if in dream, some body going to, you know, think something. It is not practically, but dream is also not useless. Dream has some position. Dream is also has some position in our life. It's not also useless. And you can say zero is useless because meaningless, foolish. Zero is not useless. A zero means nothing. A zero means nothing. But still, zero is so important. Without zero, Aryabhatta, the original mathematician, Aryabhatta, scientist, you know, is Rishi, Aryabhatta Rishi. You know, he discovered zero. Without zero, all conception also zero. So maybe you can think zero means nothing, zero is useless, but still I can prove. Without zero, everything is also zero. It is so valuable. Without zero, you cannot find any conception of mathematics, higher mathematics, you know. Especially, you know, those, you know, calculus, everything. All you will have to understand zero. Without zero, all useless. So, zero is useless, but zero is so, you know. Suppose I write one digit I write, 8. After that, if I go on writing 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, the more I write 0, the more it becomes valuable. Then 0 has some specific position in mathematics. And in negative integer, if I say minus 1, you know, that also if I say minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, if I put, you see, or before, 0.000001, minus 0.001. So it has some value. Those who are having basic conception of mathematics, they surely understand my point, I think so. So this conception, quoted from Upanishad by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, is not false, not at all useless. Without this conception, we cannot have any clear idea about tathastha position, which is very dangerous. Follow what I say. So dream, in dream it is written that jivas watching both, you know, sight, it is tathastha, avastha, both they are watching, it is written philosophically. So in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, another sloka we find, you know, Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, 4, 3, 9 slok I discuss. Another Brihadaranyaka, 2, 1, 10 sloka I going to speak. Jathagnehe spulinga bispulinga bucharati bucharanti. Spulinga bucharanti. Printing mistake. Yathagnehe khudra bispulinga buccharanti evam mevasmad atmanaha ... After that sarvani bhutani buccharanti. It is written. It is compared with some spark coming out of big fireflies. It is compared with that. And Brihadaranyaka another going to compare, you know, 4, 3, 18 sloka. Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, from there, Bhaktivinoda going to quote another sloka from Brihadaranyaka, 4, 3, 18 sloka. Tad yatha, what is the status of jivas? Tad yatha mahamatso uvekule anusancharati purvancha parancheiva mevayam purusho etavat ubhau ananto anu sancharanti sapnantoncho buddhantoncho. You know, tad yatha matse ubhe kule anu sancharanti purvancha parancheiva mevayam purusho etau ubhau anantau anusaranchi. Here it is written, just like dream, in dream ajivatma can feel some bliss. Again, when dream break up, is being material world, it can be compared just like a dream, jivatma. Because since sarupa and find from tathastha condition there, so what wrong in if we can, you know, represent in to understand this philosophy in this way? No, nothing wrong in it. Now Bhaktivinoda was speaking, the chit shakti of Ishwar is asim, infinity. Maya shakti is also infinity. And in between this tathastha shakti, tathastha all jivatma infinity, sukshma ananta, sukshma jivgan is there. We can imagine Krishna tathastha shakti From there, those jivas coming. So naturally, the inherent potency of jiva is also going to show tato svabhav. Because those tatasa jivas, they can find both feasible, they can find suitable for eternal world, nitya seva, eternal bondage condition. You know, in Vedanta Sutra we can find jagat vyapar bharjanam pakaranat sannihita tvat. In Vedanta Sutta it is written, the jiva tatasya svabhav par jagat vyapar bharjanam pakaranat sannihita tvat. In Brahma Sutra, Brahma Sutra 4.4.17. This is going to prove that all infinities, Chidatma, Nikil Chit, all Achit, I mean material jagat, Idam jagat, all controlled by the Supreme Divinity, one Brahma, nobody else. That Parabrahma Paratpar, Akhileshwar going to maintain everything. Except that, all other function can be done by Mukta Jiva. Bhagavan can translate that much power in him, that Jivatma. He can do. But except this Jagat controlling of Yoga, Srishti, creation, everything, it is written in Vedanta Sutta, Jagat Vyapar Varjanam Pakaranat Sannihita Tvat. Bhattajiv can do, Bhagavan can translate all power, but except this, you know, creation, Srishti, controlling everything, no. It's only duty of that Parabrahma, Paratvara, Akhileshwar, nobody else can do it. So now you see, we are going to understand this point, that Tatastha condition, Sabhav, Bhava is eternally present. At the same time, also it is true, Jive Sarupai Krishna Nitya Das, you cannot prove that it is false. You cannot also prove that it is false. How to reconcile this point? So infinitesimal chit particle, Jivatma coming from the Tatastha Sakti, marginal potency of Supreme Lord Sri Krishna. So naturally Jivatma is related to Krishna according to Achinta Vidavetata. Those Jivatmas are part and partial, I already told from Gita, Mamayivamsa Jiva Loka Jiva, but Achinta Vidavetata, related to Krishna, is related, Krishna is 100% related to all Jivas. By Achinta Vidavet. Supreme Lord Sri Krishna, those Jivatmas are part and parcel of Supreme Lord Sri Krishna and manifestation of His marginal potency. So naturally, those Jivatmas are having both-way tendency. Both-way tendency means they can find suitable for eternal world and material world. Sometimes they can feel attraction, something is theoretically it's there. But we find from Chaitanya Charitamrita, the eternally bonded, they eternally bonded. They are eternally mukta, eternally mukta. On the basis of this conception, a marginal line of demarcation, on the basis of this conception, theory, a marginal line of demarcation has been conceived. But Sarup, in Sarup, in fine form it is there, not false. On the basis of this conception, a marginal line of demarcation has been conceived, imagined. You know, in between this transcendental world and material world. In between is material world and transcendental world. Transcendental world and material world. Follow. Which is not found in material form. Not found in the material world. You cannot locate one position which you can identify it is marginal position from where you can detect or not that. But in fine form it is there. Which is not found, this marginal position you cannot found materially, material form. Which is not practically present or at the same time which is not at all 100% false. Materially, in material conception you cannot detect. But in fine form, already there. So you see, which is not practically present, you cannot detect. But it is there. You cannot see your mind, but it is there. Follow, you see. Maya, you cannot see, you cannot detect this is Maya. But actually, by karya, by action you can find Maya is there. You cannot see Maya. This way, some points are there on the basis which we, on the basis of which we can have a clear conception about this tathastha position, which is not false. At the same time, practically you cannot catch that marginal position, which is not found in material world, in material form, which is already existing in fine form in between this material transcendental world and material world. Which is not practically present, you cannot find, or at the same time, I would say, which is not at all 100% false. You cannot say it is 100% false, you cannot say, not possible. I can prove. Just like the conception of ideal gas, those who are going through college and university, they know physics, chemistry, they know. The conception of ideal gas is there. Ideal gas means it is named, the name given ideal gas. But ideal gas is not at all possible to have. But ideal gas, the conception of ideal gas, 100% there in physics, chemistry. Otherwise we cannot calculate. We can take up Kelvin scale on the basis of which we can calculate everything. Just like the conception of ideal gas has been accepted in physics, chemistry, higher physics, higher chemistry, as per the standard of Kelvin scale. Follow. It is not false. Just like the conception of ideal gas has been accepted in physics and chemistry as per the standard of Kelvin scale, the ideology is very, very important. This ideological conception can help us to realize the marginal condition of all jivatmas. We know for sure that Supreme Lord eternally present and those infinitesimal, infinity jivas are also eternally present. No doubt in it. But how and when those jivas become bonded? Bahirmukha, that is the main question. Krishna Buli Shei Jiv Anadi Bahirmukh, already given it. Infinite, for infinity period, they are in bonded condition. Bhaktivinoda speaking, bonded condition for infinity period is there in jiva, but that doesn't mean they cannot get free. They cannot become mukta. It is not. Krishna Buli Sai Jeev Anadi Bahirmukh. When and how? There is a question coming. This question cannot. And now, if somebody is going to put this question, how and when? This question coming? No. This question at all coming. It is useless. Because it is written, Krishna Buli Sai Jeev Anadi Bahirmukh. For infinity pure, they are bonded. I also, saw from Shastra. If somebody is going to put when and how the jiva going to get bonded, this question is obsolete, cannot stand. Because no starting point can be found. In jiva exist two status, mukta avastha and baddha avastha. In jiva itself, already in Bengali Harikatha, tomorrow morning I am speaking, Vidya and Avidya both there in, inside Bhadra Jiva. Vidya and Avidya both there. So, in Jiva, both exist Vidya and Avidya. In Jiva exist two status like liberated condition and bonded condition both there, in fine form. The ideology, the ideological conception of Tathastha Bhava of Jiva is also present in superfine form, but this does not indicate a third stage of Jiva's existence. Follow. There is some certain condition, Tathastha Jiva, we can go and find, detect Tathastha position, not there. Follow what I say. His Tathastha Bhava of Jiva is also present in super fine form, but this does not indicate a third state of Jiva's existence. Follow what I say. Nitya Baddha, Nitya Mukta, I already discussed, only those two stages are available category. In between them, the conception of marginal potency, Tathastha Jiva is there. Conception is not false. So, Nitya Baddha, Nitya Mukta, only these two stage or categories can be found, and the third stage, marginal or Tathastha, is only a positive assertion or conception on the basis of which it can be easily understood the constitutional position of Jiva. Not that Tathastha conception all false, we can throw it into garbage. Not that. The word marginal potency, the word marginal potency indicates the pure and untouched, unalloyed, untouched condition of Jivatma. Untouched by Maya or matter, the eternally present Jivas already having a capacity of self-revealed knowledge and bliss, but not yet feeling the attraction for the Chinmaya Nitya Jagat. Follow. This is only a positive assertion, conception, which is practically one kind of nirvisheshvada stage. Follow, it is one kind, it can, if you try to forcefully try to get meaning, that means it is one of nirvisheshvada. No seva, no maya, it cannot so have. It is nirvisheshvada stage. With, you know, follow. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, we can find the Siddhanta Vichar of Sivan Mahaprabhu in the following way. Nitya Baddha, Nitya Mukta. These are the two categories of infinitesimal chit particle, infinity jivatmas there. One eternally bonded condition jivas and another eternally liberated condition of jiva. Since time immemorial, without any beginning, those two stages of or categories of jivas are found, nothing else. Now, suppose one bonded soul going to enter into Nitya Jagat. Try to understand my example. Now, suppose one bonded soul going to enter into Nityanandamaya Chit Jagat. Then automatically, automatically, knowingly or unknowingly, see, I mean that Jivatma, Tatastha Shakti Chit particle, has to cross over this marginal line of demarcation. Don't understand. Try to follow what I mean to say. Now suppose one bonded soul going to enter into Nitya Jagat. Follow. After Guru Kipa, this, that, so many, you know, doing bhajan, after that, going to get eternal seva, eternal. Now suppose one bonded soul going to enter into Nitya Anandamaya Chit Jagat, then automatically, knowingly or unknowingly, that Jivatma, see, that Jivatma, that Tatasya Shakti, Chit particle, has to cross over. She has to cross over this marginal line of demarcation. Yes or not? Yes or not? Automatically, knowingly or unknowingly, she is going to cross in that marginal. Without marginal, where you can jump? Where to jump? How to jump? See, that means that Jivatma has to cross over this marginal line of demarcation, which is called Tatastha line. Here, the case of Ajamil can prove this point, because he was somehow favorable to Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan Seva. Follow what I say. Because he was somehow favorable to Guru, Vaishnava and Bhagavan. Somehow favorable. Not opposite. But still there was no sufficient chitbal power inside the heart of Ajamil, so that he couldn't find any protection from Maya, material attraction. So naturally he was bound to feel the attraction, I mean influence of Maya, so he was totally defeated. All his morality, purity, etc., all gone. He was totally in a fall down condition to live japa, seva, everything, knowingly or unknowingly. He was bound to cross over this material marginal line of demarcation of Tatastha Bhava. Yes or not? Yes or not? Such conception, such countless cases can be found in 14 worlds. Abrahma Bhuvana Loka Punaravartinaha Arjuna. Such countless cases I can show. I can give example from mathematics. Follow. From any positive digit, try to understand mathematics. From any positive digit, positive digit means not minus. From any positive integer or digit, if we like to go to any negative digit, then surely we will have to cross over zero. In front of you, it is only one conception. But surely, from any positive digit or integer, if you like to approach to a negative word, then surely you will have to knowingly, unknowingly, you will have to cross over zero, the neutral point. So the conception of marginal, condition is not at all baseless or fictitious. Surely this has some value. The relationship between Bhagavan and Jiva is surely eternal, I mean without any beginning point, but still it is missing. Without any beginning point from which we can calculate. But eternally it is present. That's why Jive Sarupai Krishna Nitya Das. Really so. So many examples I can give. Either we can find any starting point, neither we can find any starting point nor we can discover any end point. Though jiva cannot realize, the eternal relationship with Krishna, but still, this can never be ignored. This is not at all false. Eternal lesson is there. Jivatma, those jiva cannot feel that they have eternal relationship with Krishna. That doesn't mean that the jivatmas, they have no relationship with Krishna. We cannot say. Follow. If a son is missing from father, separated from father, after birth, they are missing. If a son is just missing, you know, separated from his father for a long time, this doesn't mean that the son and father relationship is false. Maybe he cannot feel, father cannot feel, or son cannot feel. If we cannot find out any particular reason from our, if we cannot find out any particular reason, you know, from our experience bank of material experience, that surely we cannot find any example from our experience bank, that surely doesn't mean that this is false. To discover this eternally present relationship of jiva with Supreme Lord, we'll have to get sammandha jnana. It's called sammandha jnana, which is only available by the causeless mercy of Guru Vaishnava. Then and only then, at all the question of avideya. Avideya means serving. Avideya coming in the life of any genuine sevak. Still after that, the question of attaining target. Still after that, suppose you are falling you are getting sammandha jnana, you are falling avideya, but still there is no guarantee. If you are making mistake, still after that, the question of attaining the target of prayajana means ultimate goal, prayajana, Krishna prem arising, not before that. Follow. Sammandha jnana you are getting. Sammandha janiya bhajite bhujite abhimana habadu. False ego can go away. And sammandha, after at all sammandha jnana you are going to develop, after that the avidya, I mean seva, bhajan can start coming. And if you are doing bhajan perfectly, genuine sadhak, still after that, the question of attaining target, I mean prayajana, prayantatta, Sri Krishna Prema arising, not before that. The sarupa of jiva is itself inherent in the constitution of jiva, but not at all inherent in the tatastha jiva. What do you mean to say? Same thing what I told when Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking. In sarupa itself, jiva, tatastha, bhava, identification already there. I can prove gradually. Follow. The sarupa of jiva is itself inherent in the constitution of jiva sarupa, but not at all in the inherent, not at all inherent in the tatastha jiva, who has a tendency to turn away from the sarup, Supreme Lord Sri Krishna because of feeling attraction for maya, material enjoyment. Anyway, the basic potentiality of the descendant, of the descent of Sarup Shakti, has also the subsequent revelation of jiva's nitya sarup already existing in the very nature of the jiva. That I can prove one by one, not today, already existing in the very nature of the jiva. Whereas jiva sarup can be covered up by maya, but her, I mean jiva sarup, is imbued with Sri Krishna's intrinsic sarupa shakti, can never be covered up. I can discuss this point today, not clear to you, I know. So I can try to explain one by one. Today I like to stop because I give you time to think over and again, try to find some question. Anyway, we are going to solve this problem. Nobody can stop us. Anyway, we are going to solve this problem. Bhayam ditiyo vinivesha tahasat ishat apetasya viparjaya asriti tanmayaya ato avayetvam bhaktvaik esham gurudev tatma vanchakalpaturvasya kepasindu bhavasya patitanam pavana bhavasya vyo namo.